You know, the culture is actually damn good.
Just another day being a Washington fan, huh? YouTube, what's going on? It's Juan Gotti here with another Washington football team video. And in today's video, I'm coming on here to talk about Deron Payne's father actually getting into it with Washington fans over the situation that happened with Deron Payne and Jonathan Allen Sunday night in the loss to the Dallas Cowboys. And I'm also going to talk about how I personally think Washington doesn't need to fire Ron Rivera, but I think Ron Rivera needs to recalibrate and reconsider the people that he hired to his staff. So without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. But before we do, make sure you guys go down below, leave a like on this video, subscribe if you're new, and turn on post notifications so you get notified when I upload a video about the NFL, or in this case, our Washington football team. Let's get straight into today's video. So, Deron Payne and Jonathan Allen, we all know what happened Sunday night. The fight that took place on the sidelines. And you would think with Washington getting slaughtered, getting plastered, getting absolutely rammed 56-14, that would be the topic of discussion this week. That's not the topic of discussion this week. The topic of discussion this week is the Walter Payton Man of the Year and our captain Jonathan Allen getting into it with his longtime teammate going back to college days in Alabama, fighting on the sideline in the mix of getting plastered and absolutely destroyed and slaughtered by the Dallas Cowboys. So as if that wasn't bad enough, Deron Payne's father then gets in the middle of this and starts arguing with Washington fans on social media. So let me read you guys, and you'll see it on your screen here. Let me read you guys what Deron Payne's father said to Washington fans. So the first thing he says is, first of all, Washington fans needs to find out what really happened on the sideline before you start talking about ish you don't know or don't have a effing clue about. My son will not be disrespected by no one. Allen is the female, period. My son don't bother nobody, but when disrespect him, I guess he made an error here, but when disrespect him, you will get seen about. Bloodline cut from a different cloth than these internet thugs, but please don't cross that line. He got the whole South riding. That's the first thing Deron Payne's father said. Called Jonathan Allen a female in the situation and basically said, we don't know what we're talking about. Then he goes on to say, why you don't blame Allen? Do you know what he called my son? So now he calls, now he's saying Jonathan Allen called Deron Payne something on the sideline. Then he goes on to say, if you call a man a female, Payne should have knocked Allen out. Then he says, get an effing quarterback. So he calling Taylor Heineke's trash, right? Then another guy said that he's had comments all over the place. He then called Chase Young out saying he's trash and whatnot. So Deron Payne's dad has been out here and he's been vocal before. So this is nothing new apparently to people out there that seen him comment before. This is the first time I seen him comment, right? I didn't even know this was Deron Payne's dad until they said it, right? So let me address that, right? Deron Payne's dad wants to stick up for his son. And again, that's where I think he's wrong, right? Again, I get that you want to defend your son, but you got to stand back sometimes and not just let your son fight his own battles, but also be able to hold your son accountable for the actions he played in this whole situation. Again, both guys are wrong. I mean, Jonathan Allen's wrong for throwing a right hook, but Deron Payne is wrong for basically starting this whole situation by putting his finger in a grown man's face. So, if I may be on someone's side in this situation, again, both of these guys are wrong, but I'm on Jonathan Allen's side with this, if anything, because I'm not going to allow you to put your finger in my face like I'm some type of child. That's the ultimate sign of disrespect. So I fully understand why Jonathan Allen gave him a right hook across his face. You know what I'm saying? I totally get that. You know, because you're not about to just sit here and put your finger in my face. Now, again, according to Deron Payne's dad, Jonathan Allen called him out of his name. Now, again, I don't know if that's true or not. We couldn't see what happened on the TV. We couldn't hear what happened on the TV on the sideline. But given that I somewhat know Jonathan Allen, especially at least in the public format of him being a Walter Payton Man of the Year nominee each and every year, he doesn't get the vibes of calling his teammate, his guy that he known for years now, going back to college, out of his name. Now, again, I don't know what happened. Maybe he did, especially because tempers are flaring. We're getting plastered on primetime TV. So, again, tempers are flaring, but I don't think Jonathan Allen is going to do that. So, I understand why he's protecting his son, but again, I feel like he's wrong in this situation. I think the right situation would have been, if he was going to come out and say something, was, you know what I'm saying, both of these guys were wrong for this situation that took place, and they have to be better. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to hold my son accountable for what he played in this part and leave it at that. But to go on to say Allen is a female, call out Washington fans, say we don't know what we're talking about, then go on to say that our quarterback is trash, get an effing quarterback, that's making this situation worse. Because now you are making Deron, you're basically a reflection of Deron Payne. And is this the person that Deron Payne is? I don't know. Maybe so. And his dad, again, is a reflection of him. So, hey, man, if that's how you raise your son, okay, cool. But again, I personally, if I was a parent in this situation, I wouldn't even have said anything because it has nothing to do with me. I'm going to hold my son accountable for his actions in private. I'm not going to go to social media, right? So I think, you know, I think Deron Payne's dad is in fault for this situation. I really do. And I'm glad I'm speaking on this situation because I feel like no one has spoken on this in a video format. Again, both of these guys are not right at all. But again, Deron Payne, from the looks of it, initiated this. So I just feel like I don't like how his dad is basically trying to say Deron Payne is the victim when he basically initiated this whole situation. So that's my take on this whole situation, guys. Again, both guys are wrong, but if I may pick someone's side, I'm on John Allen's side with this one. I'm not about to let no guy stick his finger in my face and I'm just gonna sit there. It's a natural reaction. I hear people say, no, both guys are wrong, but it's a human reaction. If someone is putting their finger in their face, you're gonna automatically react. You're not gonna sit there and say, oh, I'm in the middle of a game, I can't do that. No, that's not human reaction. Like, that's not humanly possible. You're going to react to the first thing you see. You know what I'm saying? So again, both guys are wrong, but I'm on John Allen's side with this one, and I feel like Deron Payne's dad should have just stayed out of this because he's making it worse by putting, you know, his comments on social media. And it's not a good look for Deron Payne at all. Moving on to the last part of the video today, I want to talk about how Ron Rivera does not need to be fired. I just think he needs to reconsider the positional coaches he hired. I think he needs to make some changes at the positional coaches this offseason. I think some coaches needs to be fired because it's always quick to jump to Ron Rivera being the issue, Scott Turner being the issue, and Jack Del Rio being the issues. Okay, I get that because they are the positional coaches. Callers, and in Ron Rivera's case, he's the head coach of the whole team. But it's deeper than that. Jack Del Rio is in charge of the whole defense. Scott Turner's in charge of the whole offense. But even more so than that, these players have positional coaches. Quarterback coach Ken Zampezi, Randy Jordan, you know, Drew Terrell, Pete Hayner, John Masco, and, you know, Steve Russ, Nate Kizer. List goes on. Chris Harris, you know, Stan Mills III. Like, it goes on. These guys have positional coaches that they are more close with than they are with the defensive coordinator. So, for an example, I think we need to move on from Sam Mills today, this offseason, because he is not leading these defensive linemen in the right direction. You know what would have been a good fit? Jim Tomsula. Jim Tom was a really good D-line coach that we didn't bring back when Ron Rivera was first brought in. And these guys love Jim Tom. I think Chase Young and Montez Sweat would be dogs with Jim Tomsula, right? I think we need to move on from Steve Russ, linebackers coach, because these linebackers are still not, you know, besides Cole Holcomb, obviously, I just feel like he's not a good developer when it comes to helping out these linebackers. I think Ron just needs to reassess his positional coaches. That's all. I don't think he needs to get fired. I think he just needs to make changes at his positional coaches. And Scott Turner could be on the hot seat. I don't want to move on from Scott Turner because, again, although he has been bad, he still hasn't had a quarterback that can really go out there and exceed his playbook. But again, if Ron has seen enough and he actually moves on from Scott Turner this offseason, I understand it, because again, I don't want to move on from him. But that's my quick 3 minutes of this segment, of this portion of the video. Let me know how you guys feel about this video as a whole. Who's wrong? Who's right? Deron Payne, Jonathan Allen, or Deron Payne and his dad, or Jonathan Allen in this situation? Who are you taking on this side in this whole debacle, man? Culture's damn good in Washington.